Hello friends, I hope you're all doing great. First of all, sorry for the last week, I couldn't make up a video. I was a bit busy. So today we are going to make a video on a proton pump theory prescribed by scientist Levitt. This is basically on the opening and closing of stomata. This is one of the most important theory and widely accepted nowadays, rather till date. And the request for this video I have got from one of my students from Mumbai. So this is for you. And fine, we'll start with that. So basically, this is something very, very interesting, and try to understand that. It's very easy though. The only thing, you have to understand the sequence. And let me tell you one thing. Each one of them, be it opening of stomata or closing of stomata, everything is happening here in a sequence. And all the sequences, they're interconnected with each other. So the moment you understand the connection, this will become very easy for you. Well, before we get into that, how the system, the whole system work, if we quickly observe the picture of a stomata, just a normal diagram, you can actually see a single stomatal opening which is being guarded by two guard cells, and at the outside of the guard cells you'll have several presence of these epidermal cells. These are nothing but your subsidiary cells or accessory cells. So something will happen in order to open or close the stomata between the guard cells as well as these accessory cells. And let me tell you one thing, students, you may encounter, like you will be having several hypotheses, several theory based on opening and closing of stomata. They're all different from each other, but you know what? All of them, all of the theory, all of the hypothesis, they share something very, very important, and that is opening of the stomata will be only and only due to the endosmosis of water into the guard cells. Closing of stomata will be only and only due to the exosmosis of the guard cells. Now I hope you have an idea about endosmosis and exosmosis. Entry of water, exit of water. So entry of water in the guard cells, exit from the guard cells. So entry of water in the guard cell will always create the opening of the stomata. Exit of water from the guard cell will always do the closing of the stomata. So this will be for 100% sure, and this is something you will find similarity among all the different types of hypothesis. Here I have chosen this, that is a proton pump theory, which is alternatively known as potassium ion concentration theory, which was prescribed by the scientist Levitt in the year of 1974. So now let's get into the topic here. First, we need to identify that when the stomata will open, when the stomata will close. As you all know, stomata is a tiny aperture on the surface of the leaf. And if it opens, the transpiration will take place. If it closes, transpiration will be stopped. So definitely, if you think photosynthesis is going on in the daytime, whenever you write the chemical equation of the photosynthesis, you also write, along with the production of food, along with the liberation of oxygen, there is also releasing of the water molecules in the form of water vapor. So how that is happening? That's only because of the transpiration. It will be released out of the plant body via stomatal opening. So in the daytime, your stomata needs to be opened. I hope that makes sense. Now let's see the series of the process, the events that will lead to the opening of the stomata. In the daytime, sunlight is present. So photosynthesis will take place. So as the photosynthesis will take place, more and more and more glucose will be produced. All the glucose, they are monomer, if you know, they are all monosaccharide. They will join with each other and they will form the polymer of the glucose, that is known as your starch. Now once the starch is formed here, this starch will start getting converted into the malic acid. Malic acid is a weak acid. So as they are very weak in nature, it will get dissociated and it will produce the malate ion and the hydrogen ion, right? So the overall step here means starting from photosynthesis till the production of malate ion and the hydrogen ion, it is happening in your gut cells. Remember that. Again, I'm saying it is happening in your gut cells. So there will be a moment when the concentration of the hydrogen ion will be more in the gut cells. So what will happen? That will lead to an efflux of the hydrogen ion, because the concentration of the hydrogen ion is gradually increasing here. So that will lead to the efflux of the hydrogen ion. That means whatever hydrogen ion was being produced inside the gut cells, it will start moving out. But moving out to where? In these accessory cells or the subsidiary cells. Remember that. So right after the following by efflux of the hydrogen ion, you can actually identify the ionic distribution will be disbalanced, because whatever hydrogen ion was producing, it is going out continuously. So what will happen? In order to compensate that, from these epidermal cells or from these accessory cells, there will be an influx of two ions. You are sending one ion out, you are getting two ions in. Try to understand that. So first is the influx of the potassium ion, and this influx of the potassium ion is being done with the expenditure of the energy. That means ATP will be utilized in the influx of the potassium ion. First thing. Along with that, chloride ion will also influx into the gut cells. And now see what happens. Whatever potassium ion was entering, it will combine with the malate ion which was produced earlier, and it will form the potassium malate. So what will happen? Due to the production of potassium malate, which is highly soluble, and due to the entry of these ions, the osmotic pressure of the gut cell increases. Of course, you are sending hydrogen ion out only, and in return, what you are getting? You are getting two ions simultaneously. You are getting potassium and you are getting chloride back to back. Right? And along with this concept, you also need to have potassium malate in your mind, which is highly soluble. And that leads to increasing in the osmotic pressure of the gut cells. Now, my question to you is, osmotic pressure is increasing. But in respect to what? In respect to these surrounding cells. That means osmotic pressure of the gut cells will be more than that of the surrounding cells. And in the osmosis, it is said that transport of the molecules will take place from the region of low osmotic pressure to the region of high osmotic pressure. And hence, endosmosis will take place, means water from the surrounding cell will start entering into the gut cells, and that lead to turgidity of the gut cells. Because ultimately what will happen, if water keep on entering into the gut cells, that gut cell will become swell gradually, and that is what we call as the turgidity of the gut cell. And hence the turgidity will occur, it will lead to the opening of the stomata. I hope this whole process is clear to you now. Right? Now we'll see what happens in the night time. Now remember, children, one thing. The prime difference between day and night is presence of sunlight, absence of sunlight. That means if sunlight is present, your photosynthesis will take place. If no sunlight, no photosynthesis will take place. So first difference here in the step. But you have started your day with a photosynthesis, and you are left with the stomata opened. That means stomata is still opened. Yes or no? That means the entry of the carbon dioxide, which was initially used up in the photosynthesis, but since there is no photosynthesis is there, this entry of the carbon dioxide will lead to accumulation of the carbon dioxide in their concentration, and that will lead to the decreasing in the pH. Why? Water and carbon dioxide will react with each other to form the carbonic acid. So the condition inside will become acidic. I hope that's clear to you now. Now here, from here the changes will occur now. Something very interesting. This acidic pH will stimulate the activation of an inhibitor of stomatal opening. Means I'll produce something inside the leaf, of course inside the guard cells, and it will lead to the closing of the stomata, and that is what we call as ABA, abscisic acid. Those who have studied plant hormones in 9th and 10th standard, they may have an idea about this. They have heard about this before. Those who have not, for them, let me tell you, there are several types of plant hormones: auxins, gibberellins, cytokinins, ethylene, abscisic acid. So one of them is the abscisic acid. Typically, abscisic acid acts as an inhibitory hormone. Now what inhibition it will bring? It will bring two inhibitions. First, it will change the permeability of the cell membrane. Don't consider the cell wall, it is freely permeable. So you have to consider the selectively permeable cell membrane. So the permeability of the cell membrane will get changed. Means what will happen? The permeability of the cell membrane will get reversed. Along with that, influx of the potassium ion, which was happening here, you see that influx of these ions will be stopped. Not only this, influx of potassium and the chlorine will be stopped here. So no more entry of these ions, first of all, right? Not only that, whatever ion is already there in the beginning, you see, some potassium ion entered in the guard cells and they created something known as potassium malate. So these potassium ions need to be sent out. First of all, I am not allowing any excess amount of potassium, but whatever has happened, whatever is present inside, those also need to be sent out. So what I am doing now, this potassium malate will get dissociated into the potassium and the malate ion, and this potassium ion will start getting out. Sir, just now you told potassium ion is basically for getting in. How you can send them out? My dear students, look at here. The permeability has already changed. Means whatever was there to take in, now those will be sent out. That is what we call as the changing in permeability. So efflux of the potassium ion will take place. So now the malate will be free. And whatever we sent out, the efflux of the hydrogen ion here, it will start showing the influx of the hydrogen ion. Again, permeability changes. So reverse, something has been happened. So what will happen? This hydrogen ion, along with the free malate ion, will again combine to get back to the original form, that is the malic acid. You see that? Malic acid. So this malic acid will again get converted into starch. And as you all know, starch is highly insoluble in nature, in the water. So, osmotic pressure of the guard cell will decrease, ultimately, which will lead to the flaccidity of the guard cells. We'll not say plasmolyzed. Rather, we'll say a state of flaccidity. And due to that, the exosmosis of water from the guard cells will be visible. And that will lead to the closing of the stomata. I hope the whole concept is now absolutely clear to you. So that's it, guys. So thank you for watching. If you have enjoyed my video, do not forget to hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, and if you have any request for the video on particular any topic, do not forget to write in the comment box down below. Definitely I will be making up videos based on your request. So this is the first video based on the request that I've got from the Mumbai student. So thank you so much. Bye bye, take care.